everybody. It's your man, Fit Man, head performance coach at the Fit Man Performance Center. And today's topic on Form Matters, we are going to investigate how to properly execute the best barbell press for building a bigger chest, the barbell neck press. Now, let's get into the five cues that will show you how to properly execute the barbell neck press. Cue number one, you want to take a wider grip on the barbell. So when we are performing the conventional barbell bench press, we typically use a medium grip with a half tuck of the elbows. Why do we do this? This allows us to have an even distribution of strength between the shoulders and the triceps and the chest. This allows us to press more weight. With the barbell neck press, we aren't looking for the even distribution of strength. We want all the stress, we want all the stimulation on the chest. So the first cue is that you want to take a wider grip on the barbell. Now, what I do is I take my index finger and I line it up with the powerlifting ring marker on the bar, okay? Now, this may vary and this may change based on your arm length, but you have to play around with different positions to find the ideal one for you. So the first cue when we are performing the barbell neck press is to take a wider grip. Cue number two, you want to raise your feet off the ground. Now, when we are performing the conventional bench press, our feet are planted on the floor. Why? This allows us to press stronger. We have more leverage. Again, with the barbell neck press, we're not looking for leverage. We're looking for ways to put more stress on the chest so that we can build bigger pecs. So what we're gonna do is that after we grab the barbell with that wide grip, we're gonna bring our feet up and we're gonna cross them at the ankles just like this, okay? This is gonna be the starting position for your barbell neck press. And what this does is that it takes that arch out of your back. You see, when the feet come down, we all have a natural arch in our back. This allows us to have leverage to press more weight. When we bring our feet up, that is gone. And now you're not gonna be able to use the same amount of weight as you would on the bench press that you're gonna be using in the barbell neck press. So make sure that you start light and build your way up. Cue number three, you are going to keep your elbows flared out. So when we have talked about the incline dumbbell bench press and the conventional bench press, typically we use that half tuck. And again, it all comes down to the same principle. Why do we use the half tuck? It gives us a balanced distribution of strength between the shoulders, the chest, and the triceps. For the barbell neck press, we're not looking for that. And we can avoid that by flaring the elbows out. When the elbows are flared out, this is going to put the brunt of the movement right on the pec. So make sure when you're set up and right before you're about to press that you don't try to tuck your elbows in. You want the elbows flared out. And again, this is gonna allow us to put more of the stimulation on the chest. Cue number four, when you unrack the barbell, you want to bring the bar down to your neck instead of your chest. So this is where the name of the movement comes from, the neck press. We're bringing the barbell down to our neck. What this does is that it creates more of a stretch in the chest, and you'll definitely feel it versus just performing a wide grip or conventional bench press. So we're gonna lay back, we're gonna grab that bar with the wider grip, we're gonna bring our feet up, our elbows are flared out, we're gonna unrack the barbell, and what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna bring the barbell down to my neck and then press up. When I come here, like a regular bench press, it's a different range of motion. So I don't feel my chest doing the actual work. I feel it a little bit, but it's not the same as it is when I bring the barbell down to my neck and my chest is doing all the work. So when we are performing the barbell neck press, make sure that bar comes down to your neck. Now, the other term for the neck press is the guillotine press. So if you come down in the movement out of control, you're going to get guillotined, okay? And it's not gonna feel good, and it's not going to look good either. So make sure when you are descending in the neck press, you have extreme control. All you're trying to do is kiss the neck ever so slightly. okay? It's a very, very, very slight kiss because your neck cannot take the force of the barbell. It's going to hurt. So, slight kiss, press up. Cue number five, what constitutes proper form in the barbell neck press? We're just gonna work from the top down. So cue number one, we're going to take a wider grip on the barbell. For me, that's the index finger at the powerlifting ring marker. Cue number two, we're gonna raise our feet up, cross them at the ankles, eliminate the leverage that we can get from the arch back. Cue number three, we're gonna keep our elbows flared out. Cue number four, we're gonna bring the barbell down to our neck, kiss the neck, and press up. And kiss the neck, and press up. That is the barbell neck press. It's clean, it's effective, and it's the best chest builder that you can perform. You'll feel your chest more in the barbell neck press than you will in any other movement. Now, you may be watching like, well, Fit Man, you only have 95 pounds on the bar. You're pretty weak. You're not showing us anything that we don't know. Let me tell you something real quick, okay? The barbell neck press is different from the barbell bench press. You may be a guy who can bench press 225 for 5, 225 for 10, maybe even 225 for 15. But when you perform the barbell neck press, those numbers will drop dramatically, as in the weight that you're using. You see, you've eliminated the help from the triceps and the front delts in this movement. You've made it a chest movement. So you're not just gonna be able to jump in and use the weight that you've normally been using unless you like going to the ER or going to the doctor because you're going to get folded. So use less weight when you are starting with the barbell neck press and then build up. And like with every other movement, you will get stronger. Implement these cues into your next chest workout and I promise you that you will feel your chest doing more of the work while you are pressing. Now, if you enjoyed this video and you learned knowledge that you can apply to your next workout, please like this video, share this video with your friends who also want to unleash their inner greatness, and subscribe to the Fit Team today. It's your man, Fit Man. Holla at a trainer when you see me at the center.